First offering is fouled off. Left-hand hitter waits. And that one fouled off. Into center. And it drops in. And that keeps the inning alive.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes.
These days, most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat, you're thinking it's going to be a pop-out, and it just kind of nestled into that spot where no one was able to get to it.
Jeff McNeil stands in. Assad makes the play, and it's out number three. Now it's the second baseman, Nico Horner. He's 0 for 1. The wind of the pitch. In the air, left field. Ortega makes the catch. One up, one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Hap takes a ball as he stands in for the second time. Pitch misses. Two balls, no strikes, the count.
Two balls, no strikes.
And now the lefty. High fly ball out into left center field. Ortega hauls it in, and there's two away. Here's Cody Bellinger. He's 0 for 1.
Cody Bellinger.
In for a strike. It's 0-1.
Cody Bellinger, no stranger to the big stage. He played in the 2007 Little League World Series. He's the 14th player ever to play in both the Little League World Series and the Major League World Series.
Ortega makes the catch, and that'll do it. Welcome back. Ready now for the fifth inning. Here's the catcher for the Mets, Francisco Alvarez. The wind to kick the pitch. Good eye right there.
1-0.
Now a very odd decision. They intentionally walked the leadoff guy. And now it's Mark Vientos. 0 for 1. He struck out swinging last time. There's a strike. That's down and in. Runner at first with no outs here. In the air, right field. And it's caught for the out. Now a long throw to first. And now it's going to be Brandon Nimmo. First offering misses the mark. Alvarez over at first with one away. And now two and nothing.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
3-0 down. Called strike right there. Left field. Hap on his horse. And there's two away. Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. In there for strike one. Runner on the goal. Pitch is low. Gomes. Too late with the throw. Safe. Runner at second. Two down. Next pitch is popped up. Candelario settles under it and makes the catch. And that is that.
To get the blessing for the brethren.
The brethren.
Brethren.
The brethren.
I got my blessing because the Father never left him.
back here at the ballpark. We head to the bottom of the fifth. So up now for Chicago, Seiya Suzuki. The pitch. Good eye right there.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
That misses the zone. Now 2-0. Line drive, base hit.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so great job there stepping up to the challenge. A lot of hitters tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything and pulled it into the gap nicely.
Ripped into center, base hit. Lead runner makes the turn at second. But he throws on the brakes, gets back to second.
Back-to-back singles, that pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Dansby Swanson stands in. Pitch misses. Ball one.
One ball. No,
no outs. Runners at first and second. Next offering upstairs.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Snap throw to first, and he's back standing. That's towards center. And Swanson is set down, and there's one away. Christopher Morel, the next Cub to hit.
Picked up an RBI in his last at bat. Still their only run of the game so far.
And it's fouled away.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boo.
Double steal. Squeeze attempt misses. And he throws it away. And in comes the runner from second to score. A big mistake there. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Here at Wrigley Field, here's the left fielder, Rafael Ortega. Ortega goes 5 feet, 11 inches, 31 years old. He joined the team as a free agent. In the air, right field, pretty well struck. That ball's carrying. Hauls it in on the warning track.
Man, I love that route. The ball was smoked. He knew he had to get back to the track right away. Turned his back on the infield, got to the spot, turned around, and made a nice catch.
Hammers that one deep left field, and forget it. A solo shot. Just like that, they move in front. It's 3-2.
He's going to have nightmares about that pitch. Perfect execution. It's not supposed to produce that result. He got hurt by a really good one there, but even a better swing at the plate.
Base is empty, one away. DJ Stewart up now for the Mets. Swing, and this one's bounced on the ground. In plenty of time to first, two away. On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. And next is the designated hitter, Daniel Vogelback.
1-0.
The 1-0. Comebacker to the mound. Tosses to first, third out. I got here's Yan Gomes. Doubled his first time up. pitch. That one missed. Puts it in the air out towards left center. He can't get there. It's a base hit. They're still chasing it as he rounds second. And a great start to the inning. A leadoff triple puts the tying run at third. Stepping in, number 40. Diving, and he can't make the play. In to score is the runner from third. It's 3-3.
Well, he comes through clutch with the RBI single. That was big. High fastball, even a little above the zone, but such a good job of staying tall on the backside, getting that barrel there to meet it just in time. I tell you what, it's not easy to do.
And it's even up.
Good approach right there. You want to get something just a little higher that you can elevate, stand on that double play.
There's a strike.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Squirts away a little bit. Nice job behind the plate there. Nobody out. Runner at first. Lined, and that's a base hit. Lead runner around second. And he's got a double.
Well, that may end up being an at-bat we go back to later on when this game is over. As soon as that one shot off his barrel, he was thinking extra bases. Really nice job of getting the bat out front, but not hooking around it or rolling over it. Just kept the swing on plane and smoked that thing into the gap.
Ian Happ up to hit. Now fly ball to right center. Tracks it down for the out. Both runners tagging from second and third. He's in on the sack fly. It's 4-3. In there safely. And they take a two-run lead. One down. Here comes Cody Bellinger. Yeah, big swing and a miss. Cody Bellinger, remember, in 2017, he won the Rookie of the Year, hit 39 homers, and that set a National League rookie home run record. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
Yeah, Boog, a tremendous athlete. He won the Rookie of the Year as a first baseman, plays center field with the tops in the game, and he's got a gold glove in right.
And that should be extra bases. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. And that's a double.
Still able to come through behind in the count right there. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ended it.
Here's the pitch. Runner breaks for third. There's a line drive to left field. Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. The run comes in to score from second. It's 6-3. Not in time. He's safe.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Nice line drive to the pole side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
Sean Reed Foley gets the ball now.
And this could be a pretty critical point.
And that one lifted in the air center field. Nimmo makes the catch. Runner tags from third. He'll score on the sack fly, and they lead by four.
Sometimes all you got to do is your job, and don't overcomplicate things. Keep it simple. Runner in third, less than two outs. Put the ball in play, and a nice job with the sack fly.
And it falls. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. You know what they say, he couldn't have thrown it out there any better than that, and certainly the case that time. Just flared it back behind the second baseman and dropped it in there.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. Swanson leads off first with two down to the inning. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Stewart makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Back here at the friendly confines, top of inning number 7, and stepping in for New York, Jeff McNeil. This one in the air, center field. That one gets down for a hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
The catcher, number 4,
Francisco Alvarez digs in now.
Now these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
In there, and it's 0-1. And a good eye there.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down. The offense has worked hard. It's shut down inning time.
Into the dive, and he got it. The throw in, tries to get back and save. Here's the third baseman, Mark Vientos. And there's the strike.
No ball, one strike.
Got him swinging. Slider got him for strike 3. Back to the top of the lineup. And here is Brandon Nimmo. Ground ball to the right side. Oh, great stop to first. That ends the frame. And welcome back. And here's the catcher, Yan Gomes. Reed Foley back to work. And first offering is fouled off.
You know, these Cubs, simply put, are producing a lot of quality swings. They have 5 extra base hits on the stat sheet so far, and that tells me they're seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well.
And now the center fielder, number 40.
With all those extra base hits, it's easy to think we're going to see that trend continue the rest of the game. They seem to be really locked in at the plate.
In the air, right side. Stewart makes the grab on the run. 2 outs, base is empty. And next for the Cubs, Nico Horner. 1-for-3. Lifted in the air, out to left. Ortega makes the catch, inning over. Here at Wrigley Field, ready to begin the 8th. Now up to hit Francisco Lindor. The wind of the pitch. That's out to center field. It gets down, a base hit. Around first and hustling for second. Safe at second. So a man aboard. So up next for New York, Rafael Ortega.
Almost drove one up.
Base open at first now. And here's the intentional walk. They might be trying to set up the double play with nobody out. So up next, Pete Alonso. He's already homered in this game. And first offering is fouled off. Righty to the plate. And now the count is even. First and second here, no outs. Out towards left center. Number 40 makes a move towards the gap. And he makes the catch. And there's one away. DJ Stewart up now for the Mets. He's already homered here in this one. On the ground, 2 ball. Swanson. Ball comes home, and he's dead at the plate. Stewart into second, and he's got a double. Daniel Vogelback at the plate. In the air, left field, down the line. Pat pulls that one down, and that. On to the bottom of the eighth. Now here is Ian Happ. The right-hander back to work. And first offering is fouled off. And the righty deals. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Nimmo has it sized up. Puts the squeeze on that one. And a quick out number one. Bellinger up to hit.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely. Try to hit the ball out of the park. Do what he loves to do.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. One down, base is empty. That one misses, and it's 2-1. That's in there.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
And that one is lifted in the air. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Suzuki in the box with two gone. And takes a look at a called strike. Next pitch inside. And now it's even 1-1. And now 1-2.
I wouldn't say the game's close right now, but it's not out of reach either. I mean, these guys really need to put up a zero on the board just to maintain a little hope.
Nimmo ranging after it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. All set to start the ninth in this one. And stepping in for New York, Jeff McNeil. Assad back to work. In the air, out towards right center. Could be extra bases. Around second now, as they still don't have it. Passes third, he wants it all. Francisco Alvarez up now for the Mets. And that one's gone into the bleachers. That'll fire up the dugout, and they're chipping away. It's 7-5.
Oh, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden, they're back in this ballgame.
Next to hit, Mark Vientos. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. Misses inside, and the count is 1-1. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Number 40 going back. Can't get there. Base hit. Now around second, going for third. And he's got himself a triple.
This offense is on fire. Three extra base hits in a row. Even though center fielders are amazing at tracking down balls these days, there's still a lot of room out there, and it's a big field. So if you hammer one to center like that, there's a decent chance you're picking up extra.
And that one gets down, fair ball. Not stopping, he's going for three. And he's in safely at third as a run scores on the play.
Hey, that's a really big RBI as he snags himself three bases in the process. He really smoked this one down the line, barreled it. Don't be surprised to ball on the ground to the corners if they come home with the baseball instead of going to first base.
On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. Now the left fielder, Rafael Ortega. First pitch, not close.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
1-0. Just missed.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Next offering is down low. So definitely a little wild right out of the gate.
Well, it could be a little tough coming from the bullpen mound to this mound, but you've got to find a way to get ahead in the count quickly. He has it. We'll see how this at-bat turns out. That just came apart right there. Four-pitch walk, and guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
And fouled off.
They need a strikeout, and you need a ball perhaps on the ground for a double play and get yourself a pop-up.
Line drive, that's a base hit. One runs in. Here's the throw, and he's in safely at third. As they take the lead, two runs come in. Now the tag at second, and he's out, trying for two. Next to hit, DJ Stewart. So one out with two aboard. Daniel Vogelback up now for the Mets.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first. And
that one lifted to left. Makes the grab. Runner tags for home. He's in there. The tag, and they get him at second. That's a double play. But one run does score on the play before the inning ends. Bottom of the ninth, and now it's switch hitting third baseman Jamer Candelario. The pitch popped up. Reed Foley pulls it down, and there's one down.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Now he breaks his bat. Toss to Alonso. Cubbies with only one out left. Next is the designated hitter, Christopher Morel. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Gets him to chase after that one.
You tie a guy up like that, you're feeling like you are in command.
And that one ripped into right. He puts it away, and that'll do it. The Mets slug their way to a win in this one.
Well, all game, these guys had to battle with that 10th man, those fans making a lot of noise. But they took the lead in the ninth inning, quieted things down, and were able to get those final three outs in the bottom half as well. Just a very well-executed ball game.
And 9-7 is the final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Shambi saying so long.
Mets, 9 runs, 12 hits, one error, they left 8 runs on base.